Between the 15th and 19th centuries, an estimated 12 million Africans were shipped from West Africa to North, Central, and South America and the Caribbean. Initially, they were mainly used as servants for the rich. The Europeans justified the enslavement of Africans by arguing that they were providing an opportunity for the Africans to become Christians. By the 17th century, the removal of slaves from Africa became a holy cause that had significant support from the Christian Church.
The village of Paye and all the wonderful people in it. It is a good and honorable thing when two people can see the ways of each other. They come together, get married, and have plenty of picnics.
You smell that?
It is a reason why I was late, sir. The goats.
I think we have divulged enough personal information here today. May I continue? Good. Because I seen Tehuaca in the village and he likes so is. Today, the people in the village of Pae have come together to celebrate so that these two people will live longer and the village will be stronger and stronger forever. Akela, that's it. Tanea Kawana, that's it. Akela, why do you want this woman?
Akela loves this woman.
What can Akela do for this woman?
Akela can give woman lots of love and plenty of picnic.
Ah, but what can Akela do for a woman?
Akela gives father 40 acres of land, 20 heads of cattle.
Does father accept this gift?
No, Simba doesn't accept the gift.
Akela gives father 10 more acres of land, 50 more heads of cattle.
Does father accept this gift now?
Yes, Simba accepts the gift.
This morning.
Eshubarak bo mojuba, eshubarak bo mojuba. Eshubarak bo mojuba, eshubarak bo mojuba. Eshubarak bo mojuba. Ate. Ate. Ate.
Arise. It is a good and honorable thing when two people see the ways of each other. They come together and create plenty of picnics and young great warriors. Let the celebrations begin.
I mean, Kwame's trips to Greece take almost as long, and the way they're talking, seems like this place is a far way off.
They say it's not that far, though. It's just kind of hidden around the corner.
Where do you get all this information?
Places.
Well, I hope you're right. And Kosi's chest is very weak, and I think a month is enough time for him to be exposed to those winds.
My chest is fine.
Well, now you have no choice but to help your father with the hunt, son. We need warm clothes for that chicken chest.
There is nothing wrong with my chest, mother.
I mean, even if it takes more than a month, I suppose it's okay, right? I mean, it's like an adventure.
It is. This should be a really good experience for your son. New employers, new time of adventure. All in all, a real good experience. You should be working under some really decent conditions.
I don't know. They look kind of rigid to me.
They do seem a bit stiff.
Yes, but I'm just thinking the exposure will be good. And in course, it will have really good conditions to work under, you know?
I'm jealous.
As always.
Why does he get to go everywhere?
Because he is 16 and you're not.
Yeah.
I was wondering though, how many people is it that they are going again?
Well, they said about 3/4 of the laborers have decided to go.
What's wrong?
I don't know. The ship seems kind of small. I mean, it's a big ship, but I just don't think everybody will be able to make this first trip. You know what I mean?
Mother, you always worry. There will be another ship.
Oh, really? Well, that means there'll be lots of space for you to explore, son. Oh, and Kosi, I'm almost tempted to say I'm as jealous as your sister. Just 3 more days with us, huh? Nervous?
Nope.
Oh my goodness, mother, you are so embarrassing. Bro, that's why I have no friends. I hate you, mother. I never return to Africa. I hate you. I am a grown man. I am a grown man. I am a grown man, mother. Unwind me. You, Pastor Yao.
Thank you. Come on, let's keep it moving.
I'm sorry, it was coming right at me.
Coming right at you?
They look so bloody strong.
You mess with my prophets, William. You sleep in the gallows with these monkeys. Get up!
Up, let's go.
Thank you.
come down here again, Captain. Pockets of sugar cane are bountiful, William. You can stand that? You can stand the pungent smell without bed.
Not this pungent.
Good God, William!
Captain, he's dying!
God damn it, William, would you wipe your mouth off?
Sorry, sir.
Come here! Why don't you just throw my money on the fire? First, you kill a perfectly healthy boy, then you let a pregnant woman aboard my ship!
Captain? Oh, I swear she wasn't showing when I saw her, sir.
What up, I'm a bit hard to believe. Can't stand the smell. I'm going to the upper deck.
Captain, it sounds like he's dying. The sea one.
He'll live.
Yeah. 1634.
Firstly, we have Frederick. Aged 18, he's a decent field hand. Next, we have Marcia. Also aged 18, she works in the grape house. Does a bit of everything, really. Then we have Chicken-Chested James. Aged 16, works in the Mills house. What do we have here, ladies and gentlemen?
Balfour.
Yes, ma'am. The notorious Balfour. Strapping young lad. He works in the curing house. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, the finest specimen yet, if I do say so myself. Willoughby. He'll make a fine overseer in the fields.
They're lovely, Captain.
Homebred.
I'll take them all.
Always an honor to do business with such a lovely lady.
Thank you. So on one side, you had God's man Moses. And on the other side, you had the man with all the power over Egypt. He had all the chariots, all the power. He decided who lived and who died. All Moses had was just an old staff. But Moses, he knew what he knew. He knew that it wasn't their power that would make them escape Egypt, but the power of God.
Slaves, obey your earthly masters with respect and fear, and with sincerity of heart, just as you would obey Christ. Obey them not only when their eye is upon you to win their favor, but, like slaves of Christ, doing the will of God from your heart.
Because the Lord has anointed me to preach good news to the poor, he has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, proclaim freedom for the captives, and free from darkness the prisoners, to comfort all who mourn, and provide for those who grieve in Zion.
Both thy bondsmen and thy bondsmaids, which thou shalt have, shall be of the heathen that are round about you, and of them shall ye buy your bondsmen and your bondsmaids. Moreover, the children of the strangers that do sojourn among you, ye shall buy, and of their families that are with you, which they begat in your lands, and they shall be your possession. And ye shall take them as an inheritance for your children after you, to inherit as a possession, and they shall be your bondsmen forever.
And Pharaoh and his camp were by the Red Sea, 600 chariots strong. And Moses and his people, they were trapped by the chariots, and by the sea, and by the mountains. And the Israelites, they were beginning to lose hope. But Moses, he stood up and shouted, "Do not fear. Stand by and see the salvation of the Lord." Then God, he parted the Red Sea, so they crossed over onto dry land, and the waters, the waters were standing up like a wall on each side of them.
A man tormented by the guilt of murder shall be a fugitive till death. Let no one support him.
Thank you.
morning.
The punishments for running away were vast. Colonies with large numbers of slaves introduced their own slave codes. The main idea behind these codes was to keep the slaves under the tight control of their owners. The death penalty was introduced for a whole range of offenses. Slaves could be executed for murder, rape, burglary, arson, assault upon a white person, and running away. Plantation owners believed that this severe discipline would make the slaves too scared to rebel.
Teach slaves to be subject to their masters in everything. To try and please them, not to talk back to them, and not to steal from them. To show they can be fully trusted, so that in every way they will make the teachings of God our Savior attractive. After everything that I have given you, after I have saved you from your own sinful selves, that one of you would so betray your master.
Oh, master, pray for the lowly mistress.
That must be the reason you feel you must betray me. Well, mind your literal interpretation of the Bible. Think about that when you are having your ceremonies at night. Observe the price that must be paid for betrayal. This boy is lucky. He has had his chance to be penitent.
Joy. Rejoice, I say, rejoice.
But well, he's the only one of us who knows what it is to be free.
Right.
Rejoice, I say rejoice. Mm-hmm. You're the right hand of God. The right hand of God. Oh, all my brothers and sisters, I say soon.
Come on.
Soon, I say soon.
Soon the white cloud will pass us by.
Soon enough, the white cloud will pass us by. Therefore, I say, since we have such a hope, we are brave. Since we have such a hope, we are brave. Moses, who behind his face and the veil, the Israelites cannot see the radiance fading away. I say to you, I say, wherever there is the Lord, there is a spirit. Wherever the Lord dwells, you will find a spirit. Wherever you find the spirit of the Lord, you will find freedom. The spirit of the Lord, you will find freedom. Soon, I say.
Thank you.
say, though?
What does it say?
Freedom?
Yeah.